Hey guys, welcome back to Power Tool Week in Review. I'm Rob. We have breaking tool news.
Our poor Makita fans have been left thirsty in the desert for so long, but Makita is finally making up for lost time and launching new tools this month, and we're going to take a look at each one. Let's go. Let's start with the all-new Makita XS-B01 18-volt LXT Brushless Detail Belt Sander. It's a 21-inch detail sander ideal for use on wood and metal in refinishing and fabrication applications. With a belt speed of 5,600 feet per minute, it's ready for just about anything. There are three different arm sizes and is compatible with quarter-inch and half-inch sanding arms. It also has an electric brake, variable speed control, and adjustable LED light. The XS-B01 is available right now in a kit with a 5-amp-hour battery and charger and a case for $470. Next up, Makita dropped two improved 18-volt X2 LXT brushless cordless wet dry vacs that claim longer runtime and even quieter operating sound levels. This is the XCV20Z and the XCV23Z. They both claim that with two LXT 5-amp-hour batteries, you'll suck all your problems away for 100 minutes and only bother your coworkers with a reasonable 64 decibels on their highest speeds. They both offer variable speed control dials, large rubber bumpers, and oversized on-off switches, and a quick-release metal latch for easy cleanup. The only real difference is the canister size. The 2.1-gallon XCV20Z is available now as a bare tool for $450, while the 4-gallon XCV23Z is available now as a bare tool for $460. Makita has been aggressively pursuing the OPE market for some time now, and this month they've shown up with some really interesting additions. First up, a new 18-volt LXT cordless string trimmer, the XRU23, which they say will give you up to an hour of runtime on one 4-amp-hour battery. Its brushless motor delivers up to 6,000 RPM, and it's controlled with a high-low button. It also has a variable speed trigger, 13-inch cutting swath, and something Makita calls
extreme protection technology,
which essentially makes it dust and water resistant. The XRU23 is available now for $155 bare or $210 in a kit. But I hear ya.
That's great, Rob, but what if I want to do 11 different things with my outdoor power tool?
Calm down, Clint. Makita also announced the new XUX02 18-volt LXT brushless cordless couple shaft power head, which will currently work with 11 different attachments. The power head features a lever-style lock, which allows for quick toolless installation and replacement of attachments. It has a loop handle for comfortable grip, a hook for a shoulder strap so you can wear it out on the town, and variable speed control. And just like the string trimmer we just mentioned, this tool also features Makita's
extreme protection technology,
dust and water resistance. The available attachments include a string trimmer, curved string trimmer, multiple hedge trimmers, pole saw, cultivator, paddle sweep, and my personal favorite, the self-grooming bristle brush.
Not what that's for.
Stay out of this, Sarah.
The couple shaft power head is available now as a bare tool for $169 and in a variety of kits that range from, oh, that's reasonable, to, ow, ow, my wallet. And last of all, the reason you're here, you want to dig an 8-inch wide hole 41-inch deep, sicko. Well, Makita's got you covered. This is the all-new Makita XGD01 18-volt X2 LXT brushless cordless earth auger that they claim matches the power of a 36cc gas competitor while weighing 30% less, with two different speeds ranging from 0 to 1400 RPM. It features automatic speed change tech, which adjusts the drill speed and torque during drilling, a reverse switch, torque limiter, and a built-in LED for digging late at night while your spouse sleeps. The new Makita XGD01 is available right now for $599 bare or $720 in a kit with 5-amp-hour batteries. There are three auger drill bits available in 4, 6, and 8 inch for $125, $130, and $140 respectively.
To make sure you don't miss any Power Tool news, be sure to like and subscribe, and catch us this Friday for the Power Tool Week in Review.